Eye media campaign was announced at a Fresno press conference today. Don't be the eye in DUI to encourage everyone to enjoy the holidays safely. I'm Emma Ott with all the details tonight at 8.
A new California gun law overhauls the process to legally carry a gun. I'm Shayla Gaitan with those details tonight.
Also tonight, Fowler police need your help to locate a man who's allegedly luring young children. And we are in storm mode.
If you live up in the mountains, what you lived through last year, if you live out in rural areas, if you need sandbags, go get them.
Reporter Gavin Martin will have all of the details as your news in primetime is next.
New. Local. Unique. MyTV 53 News at 8 starts right now.
Hope you had a great weekend. Welcome to the San Joaquin Valley's only 8 p.m. news. I'm Austin Reed. It is Monday, the 18th of December. Thanks for joining us as we are just 1 week away from Christmas. And impaired driving remains a significant public safety concern, which has devastating consequences for individuals, families, and communities. To address this issue as holiday traffic is here, the California Office of Traffic Safety held a news conference earlier today to announce a new statewide campaign that aims to raise awareness about the dangers of impaired driving. MyTV 53's Emma Ott joins us from Northwest Fresno with more in our big story.
The Don't Be the Eye in DUI campaign encourages Californians to take personal responsibility in celebrating the holidays this year.
Impaired driving remains a significant public safety concern that has devastating consequences for families, individuals, and communities. To address this issue, the California Office of Traffic Safety, Caltrans, California Highway Patrol, the City of Fresno, and Fresno PD held a press conference today to announce the new campaign. Mayor Jerry Dyer was there as well to speak.
After spending over 40 years in law enforcement, I saw far too many tragedies caused by intoxicated drivers, people that were driving under the influence, whether it be alcohol or drugs. Too many families having to bury a loved one unnecessarily.
The public service announcement will run through the first week of January and will feature videos in both English and Spanish on various digital platforms, including radio and billboards.
Driving under the influence of alcohol and drugs, it remains one of the leading causes of deadly crashes, killing, and I hate saying this, but killing four people in California every day. Just let that sink in for a moment.
In 2021, 1,370 people died in California in alcohol-involved impaired driving crashes, representing a 16% increase from the previous year. So far this year, 8 people have died in DUI-related crashes in the city of Fresno, up from 7 people killed over the same period last year. In Fresno alone, more than 2,275 DUI arrests were made this year.
2021, we had 21 people killed in our city as a result of a DUI. 21 families that had to bury a loved one in our city unnecessarily. And those who drink and drive have two things in common. They think they are okay to drive. And secondly, they do not think they will get caught. And they are wrong in both cases.
The CHP, OTS, Caltrans, City of Fresno, and Fresno PD wants to remind drivers that driving under the influence of any substance that affects your ability to drive safely is illegal. If you plan on drinking or consuming drugs that may impair, plan on a designated sober driver, staying the night with family or friends, or, of course, using public transportation. Remember, always choose a sober way to go.
I'm Emma Ott, reporting with MyTV 53 News at 8.
All right, Emma, thank you for that. Well, new at 8 now. On Sunday afternoon, CHP Fresno received a call of a crash on northbound 99 at 41. Preliminary investigation indicates a 21-year-old male of Fresno was driving a silver Toyota southbound on 41. The driver made an unsafe turn to the left and allowed the Toyota to travel into the southbound State Route 41 center median. The Toyota traveled in a southerly direction between 41 and the southbound lanes. The Toyota traveled down a dirt embankment and overturned. Now, the Toyota came to a rest on its roof on the east shoulder of 99. As a result, the driver sustained fatal injuries and was pronounced dead at the scene. It is still unknown if drugs and or alcohol were factors. New from Fresno PD, on Friday night, 8 people were arrested for DUI at a DUI checkpoint in Fresno. The checkpoint was held at Shaw Avenue and 4th Street from 9 p.m. to 4 a.m. Saturday. 18 drivers were cited for operating a vehicle unlicensed with a suspended or revoked license. 168 vehicles were actually contacted. The next DUI enforcement operation will be a checkpoint scheduled for December the 22nd. Here is a talker to start the week off. Holy cow. What do you do when there's a cow on the loose and there's not a cowboy in sight? You use your vehicles to corral it near a fence. Over the weekend, animal control officers Vasquez and Rafferty responded to Old Lake Road in Merced County for a cow on the run. They quickly used their vehicles to corner the cow right near a fence away from traffic. The owner was contacted and arrived to take the cow back to greener pastures. All right, if you are a gun owner, listen up. Big changes are coming for CCW holders in just a couple of weeks from now. Fresno County Sheriff John Zanoni stopped by the MyTV 53 Broadcast Center today to give us more insight about it. New at 8, reporter Shayla Gaitan brings us the full story from the newsroom.
Well, Austin, Senate Bill 2 will double the amount of training for applicants and a deeper background investigation.
So with SB 2, this bill was enacted, first off, on the belief that it was going to reduce violence within our communities.
This new bill was passed in the wake of the Supreme Court's decision to expand the right to carry firearms in public. In response, this new gun law will double the amount of training for new applicants up to 16 hours and renewals from 8 hours, also restricting where it can be carried. Some no-go areas would include public parks, schools, bars, and others. Senate Bill 2 will also conduct a more rigorous background check specifying those who cannot be licensed to carry. This background check will include references, social media, and even spouses to legally qualify. Sheriff John Zanoni visited the MyTV 53 studio today to speak on the issue.
I think this is an overreach by our state government on this. And it's also going to increase the amount of time that you need in training for someone who's getting a brand new issued gun permit from 8 hours to 16 hours. If you're getting yours renewed and you're a current CCW holder, it goes from 4 hours to 8 hours. Which the additional training, training is good. If it helps prevent some accidental discharges or it makes people safer or better at carrying their concealed firearm, I'm all for it. There is some changes to the appeal process, which are going to make it a lot more labor intensive and are going to require other parties to get involved instead of just our staff at the sheriff's office.
This new law will take place beginning January 1st of next year. I'm Shayla Gaitan with MyTV 53 News at 8.
Thank you, Shayla. All new from Fowler Police. They need your help. On December 14th, they got a call regarding a person following a young girl walking her dog. The family member said that he was attempting to lure the young girl near his vehicle. So tonight, police say the SUV is a red 2020 Mitsubishi Outlander. Police also say that a similar incident was recently posted online from the Woodward Lake area. That person was walking her dogs when the possible same vehicle pulled near them. On Monday, Fowler Police released an update and said they now have a person of interest. The suspect has been identified as Jeffrey Herbert. This just into the MyTV 53 newsroom. On Sunday at about 3:50 a.m., Michael Watts was found unresponsive at the Federal Correctional Institution in Mendota. Responding employees initiated life-saving measures. Mr. Watts was subsequently pronounced deceased by EMS personnel. No employees or other incarcerated individuals were injured, and at no time was the public in danger. Watts was a 43-year-old male who was sentenced in the Middle District of Tennessee to a 120-month sentence for distributing meth. He had been in custody at FCI Mendota since January 20th of 2022. Visalia Fire responded to an early morning blaze at the Carl's Jr. on Main Street over the weekend. Around 4 a.m. Sunday, VFD were called to the Carl's Jr. for a report of a grease fire. When crews arrived on scene, they discovered the blaze had extended into the exhaust vent. Crews had the fire under control within about 10 minutes. All employees had also evacuated safely prior to VFD arriving on scene. Nobody was injured. No one else was injured. The cause of the fire still under investigation. But a heads up, Carl's Jr. will now be closed until repairs and cleanup of the fire is complete. And finally, in your first few minutes of nonstop news at 8, get ready for an active weather pattern which started this morning. New at 8, reporter Gavin Martin is in storm mode for us. New tonight.
A winter storm warning will soon be in effect for the Sierra Nevada above 8,000 feet from 4 a.m. Tuesday morning until 10 Thursday morning. The majority of this snow will fall Tuesday afternoon and Tuesday night. Winds may gust as high as 45 miles per hour. Travel in the higher elevations of Yosemite National Park may be extremely difficult or impossible. Due to this storm, it will result in high elevation snow in the Sierra Nevada. Snow levels will start around 8,000 feet Tuesday before dropping to about 7,000 feet Wednesday afternoon. This graph shows rain amount probabilities for select locations in the San Joaquin Valley from 4 a.m. Wednesday and until 4 a.m. Thursday. Most locations have a 50% or higher chance for receiving over a half an inch of rain.
If you live up in the mountains, what you lived through last year, if you live out in rural areas, if you need sandbags, go get them. If you live in a low-lying area and you flooded last year, and you think you need something, you can always contact, Fresno County Public Works.
Reported from MyTV 53 News at 8, I'm Gavin Martin.
Gavin, thank you. And that does do it for your first few minutes of nonstop news at 8. But don't go anywhere. We are just getting started. Still ahead, we will take a look at your big stories in Kern County for our viewers watching on KNXT. The Kern County Fire Department has some helpful reminders when it comes to Christmas tree fires. Sally Soper will explain. Later, Pope Francis has formally approved allowing priests to bless same-sex couples. And it is going to be an active weather week. We'll have your full weather forecast coming up as well. New, local, unique. This is MyTV 53 News at 8. Don't go anywhere. We're back in a little over 2 minutes.
This is MyTV 53 News. New, local, unique, with Austin Reed. You're watching MyTV 53 News at 8.
Hey, welcome back, everybody. Thanks for staying with us. Now to our big stories in Kern County for our viewers watching on KNXT. New tonight, vehicular manslaughter charges have been filed in an officer-involved collision case. Today, Kern County District Attorney Cynthia Zimmer announced the significant case filing. On Friday, the Kern County District Attorney's Office filed felony vehicular manslaughter charges against Ricardo Robles relating to a collision that happened on January 19th, 2023, when Robles was employed as an officer with the Bakersfield Police Department. The charges filed include one count of vehicular manslaughter, a felony, when Robles is arrested or surrenders on the arrest warrant, an arraignment date will be set. The look of Golden West Casino's new home north of Meadows Field Airport in Bakersfield is coming into fruition with the release of these new renderings. The casino will be built at the northwest corner of Merle Haggard Drive and Landings Way. Kern County Associates LP told Bakersfield.com that its over 30,000 square foot building will contain 45 tables for playing a wide range of gaming options with up to 10 seats per table. There will be a contemporary casual restaurant, exclusive VIP lounge, versatile event spaces, and entertainment facilities. The company won permission in late October to proceed with the complex. You can learn more about this online at bakersfield.com. Well, the County of Kern is highlighting the fire department's Christmas tree safety tips. New tonight, reporter Allie Soper has more.
Welcome to this week's Around Kern County. I'm your host, Allie Soper. We're a little over a week away from Christmas, and the Kern County Fire Department wants to make sure our residents celebrate safely. This week, they held a Christmas tree hazard demonstration to show our community that by taking a few simple steps, we can keep our holiday season hazard-free.
So a few things that will help individuals to avoid safety hazards in the home is to make sure that there are no heat sources within 3 feet of the tree. So if you're choosing a location for the tree, make sure it's not right next to a space heater or fireplace. Use a tree stand that will allow you to water that tree. That tree will thus slow down in the drying process, and a dry tree is a dangerous tree. So keeping it watered keeps it from drying out, keeps it less likely to burn.
I still cannot believe it's only 1 week until Christmas. That was Allie Soper reporting.
My TV 53 News continues with the Valley's local forecast.
We're back in the Christmas spirit, where this morning Visalia police officers helped bring joy to local families at the Toys for Tots toy drive at Century 21. They distributed toys that had been collected from the Stuff the SWAT truck event.
Santa, make him hurry, tell him he can take the freeway down.
And tonight, the department says they are truly grateful for the community, Century 21, and Toys for Tots for bringing smiles to many children's faces this holiday season. New tonight, Pope Francis has formally approved allowing priests to bless same-sex couples with a new document explaining a radical change in Vatican policy by insisting that people seeking God's love and mercy shouldn't be subject to, quote, an exhaustive moral analysis to receive it, end quote. The document from the Vatican's office released today elaborates on a letter that Francis sent to two conservative cardinals that was published in October. In that preliminary response, Francis suggested such blessings could be offered under some circumstances if they did not confuse the ritual with the sacrament of marriage. At least 86 people have died and 96 others were injured after an earthquake in northwest China. That's according to the state broadcaster CCTV. They reported it Tuesday morning, China time. The quake, which hit China's Gansu province late Monday evening our time, prompted the deployment of rescue workers, including officials from local emergency management and fire departments. The USGS survey said earlier that a magnitude 5.9 quake in the area had caused severe shaking with extensive economic damage, probable and likely widespread. The earthquake had a shallow depth at just over 6 miles. All right, still ahead here at 8. We're talking about Twin Day. Plus, Fresno County Supervisor Nathan Magsig takes us to Cressman's General Store and gas station following the devastating Creek Fire. Details coming up next in Prime Time. Hey, new tonight, Fresno County Supervisor Nathan Magsig has a fresh update from Cressman's General Store and gas station where the Creek Fire devastated that community a few years ago.
And of course, here with me is Ty Gillette. He's the owner of Cressman's. And Ty, what's going on with the plans to rebuild out here? I know you've been working on that for a long time.
We have, yeah. It's a surprisingly long process. There's a lot of people involved. Everything's pretty complicated, more than you'd hope, but we're getting there. We've got plans just about ready to go in for final submittal to the county. Our pad's ready to go. We're ready to get going.
You know, I absolutely love Cressman's. When you think about the history of what this place has meant to Fresno County and many families over the generations, a lot of loggers would stop here at this location. And you think about how Fresno County really was built. There were two long flumes. One came from Shaver Lake, another one came from Hume Lake, one to Sanger, one to Clovis. And Cressman's has been there all throughout, you know, the decades.
That was Nathan Magsig. All right, finally tonight, today is a special day. It's December 18th, which means it is National Twin Day, celebrating all the siblings who enjoy the unique connection because they share a birthday. Whether fraternal or identical, twins share everything right from the beginning. While their personalities may be different, they often know what the other is going to say before the words are even spoken. And I had to share this picture. Here are my twins, Madison and Mackenzie. They're not identical. They are fraternal. They are very similar in some ways, very different in others. So happy Twin Day. Let's get a final look at your forecast. From Fresno to Bakersfield, it's going to be an active weather week. A lot of snow in the mountains, a lot of rain here in the valley. So keep that in mind. As you could see on your 7-day forecast, it's going to be interesting. So we'll keep you posted here on the news at 8. Hey, thanks for joining us on this Monday. I'm Austin Reed, hoping your news is good news. We'll see you tomorrow. Have a good rest of your evening. From all of us at MyTV53, we wish you a very Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, Winter Solstice, and here's to a joyous new year. Thanks for watching your favorite locally owned and operated station. We are MyTV53.